Smart Drivers, Rick with Smart Drive Test, talking to you today about the governor in an air brake equipped vehicle. The only difference between a compressor in a shop or a garage and the compressor on an air brake equipped vehicle is that the air compressor on an air brake equipped vehicle runs the entire time the motor is running. So we need some way to control it. The governor is the way that we will control the compressor on an air brake equipped vehicle. We're going to talk to you today about how it does that. We'll be right back with that information. Smart Drivers, Rick with Smart Drive Test, talking to you today about the governor on the air compressor. As I said in the introduction, the compressor on an air brake equipped vehicle runs the entire time that the motor is running. And because the compressor is capable of pumping up to 500 pounds per square inch, we need some way to control it. Otherwise, the air that is compressed by that compressor could potentially be dangerous and pose risk to yourself and other people in and around your vehicle. The governor does this by the load and unload phase. And essentially what it does, it's kind of like a railway switch. Puts it into a load phase where it pumps air into the system, or it puts it into the unload phase where it pumps air into the atmosphere. You can kind of think of the relationship between the governor and the compressor kind of like the bossy wife and the lazy husband. The bossy wife tells the husband, go out and cut the grass, so the compressor goes into the load phase and starts pumping air into the system. When it's done pumping air into the system, we're at the maximum pressure, which in most air brake systems is 135 pounds per square inch. The wife says, okay, you're all done, you can go in. He goes in, sits on the couch, watches telly, drink beer, and belches. That's the relationship between the governor and the compressor, and think of it like that. Or you can change the sexes to one or the other. The governor controls the compressor, puts it in the load phase, the unload phase, or the cut-in, cut-out, as it's called in Ontario and other jurisdictions. You can find the video for the compressor here to get more information about the compressor. I'll put a card up for you there. The other thing about the governor, the other analogy that works really well is think of the governor like a thermostat on a furnace. When the temperature in the house goes down to a minimum, the thermostat turns the furnace on. When the temperature goes back up to a maximum, the thermostat turns the furnace off. A governor works exactly the same. So the minimum and maximum that the governor works in an air brake equipped vehicle is 80 pounds per square inch on the minimum, 135 pounds per square inch on the maximum. Now, most modern air brake systems work within 20 pounds between maximum and minimum. So therefore, if the air brake system works at a maximum of 125 pounds, it's going to work at a minimum pressure of 105, so the governor will return it. The reason we go to 80 is so that, you know, the old timers who got their 1956 Pete, they can still drive them. They'll still pass the air brake test because the governor will put the compressor back into the load phase by a minimum of 80 pounds per square inch. Now, as part of your pre-trip inspection, for the purposes of a road test and for the purposes of ensuring your vehicle is safe, you have to test the compressor and you have to test the governor. The two tests for the governor are that you pump down to above 80, throttle up a little bit, and watch the needles climb. If the needles are climbing, you know that the governor has put the compressor back into the load phase. The way that you know that the governor has put the compressor into the unload phase is you pump up to maximum pressure. At maximum pressure, the air dryer is going to purge. You're not going to hear anything else. You're not going to hear the compressor. You're not going to hear the governor. The governor's kind of like Arnie. You know, Arnie was the governor of California. He's going to kill you all silent-like. The governor does the same thing. You're not going to hear it. The air dryer, at maximum pressure, the air dryer will purge. Confirm by looking at the needles. The needles have stopped climbing. It's like a glass of water. When you fill it up and you stop putting water in it, the water level stops rising. The needles have stopped climbing. Therefore, I know that the governor has put the compressor into the unload phase at maximum pressure between 105 and 135 in most provinces in Canada. So that's the governor test that you have to do as part of your pre-trip inspection for the purposes of a road test and to ensure your vehicle is safe. In conclusion, the compressor runs the entire time that the motor is running on an air brake equipped vehicle. Therefore, we need some way to control it. We control it with the governor. The governor puts the compressor into the load phase where it pumps air into the system, or the unload phase where it pumps air into the atmosphere. In Ontario and other jurisdictions, they call it the cut-in phase or the cut-out phase. Think of it a little bit like a railway switch. Right? It's either on the main track or it's in the side track. And when the compressor is in the unload phase, it just kind of hangs out and cools off and doesn't really do too much. until it's put back in the load phase or the cut-in phase, and then it pumps air back into the system. Think of the governor like a thermostat on a furnace. When it gets to minimum, it turns it on. When it gets to maximum, it turns it off. A governor works exactly the same. As part of your pre-trip inspection, you have to test the governor. You have to test the minimum setting, which is it has to return the compressor to the load phase by a minimum of 80 pounds per square inch, and it has to put it in the unload phase at maximum pressure between 105 and 135 in British Columbia and other provinces. In Ontario, it's between 80 and 135, but most of the time it'll be around 125. So you know it's at maximum pressure, the air dryer purges, you look at the needles have stopped climbing, and the system is between 80 and 135 pounds per square inch in Ontario. That's the test for the governor and the criteria for the governor. Question for my smart drivers. Have you ever had a governor fail and causing it to build up where the safety valve has engaged? The safety valve sounds like a machine gun. So have you ever had a governor fail on an air brake equipped vehicle? Leave a comment down in the comment section. All those stories are great. All those stories help out the new drivers we're trying to help out here on the channel. If you like the video, subscribe, share, leave a comment down in the comment section. All of that helps us out. If you like what you saw here, head over to my website. Lots of practice driving test questions for air brakes. In Ontario and other provinces, you have to take a theory test on air brakes every 5 years when you renew your license. Lots of practice driving test questions. They teach you how to take the multiple choice driving test questions, and they teach you about all of the numbers, specific numbers you need to know to do the air brake pre-trip test for the purposes of the theory test that you need to take at the MTO. I'm Rick with Smart Drive Test. Thanks very much for watching. Remember, pick the best answer, not necessarily the right answer. Have a great day. Bye now.